The Revelation, Chapter 1. The revelation of which God gave unto him, to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass. And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John, who bare record of the word of God, and of the testimony of
God,
and of all things he saw. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. John to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace be unto you, and peace from him which is, and which was, and which is to come, and from the seven spirits which are before his throne, and from who is the faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead, and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us.
Vice Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral Lisa Franchetti, told the House Armed Services Committee last month that the Navy is projected to fall 6,000 recruits, or 16%, short of its goal for enlisted sailors this fiscal year. So, they're exploring new recruitment strategies, such as this one.
We reached the moon, but lost in space, I think we got there all too soon. But you know what? I'm coming back for you, baby. I'm coming back for you.
And if that doesn't convince young men to join the Navy, there's this.
La la la, this throat Lady Gaga, boys say hallelujah, give me that ya 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 ya.
Shalom, I would like to give out.
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I would like to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh, Bahashem, Rakakadash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS, who rule well, teach well, being great examples to all his younger brothers. And peace and blessing, salutation to the hopeful elect out there pushing his word in truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh, pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopeful elect, the believers and listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh, Bashem, Al-Shah. All right, and what I want to get into is respond to a lesson, you know, done by the up-and-coming elder Shaquat out of the Mississippi camp, you know, down here in the channel GMS Dedication. You know, please subscribe and be edified. You know, brother, you know, goes in heavy, you know, with current events, you know, news clips, and, you know, what's going on, you know, so please subscribe, you know, be edified, you know, and be kept in the loop, you know, of, you know, current events, you know, and edification. Now, what I wanted to get into, okay, as you've seen the madness, okay, of the new Navy military recruitment, okay, and just shows you the filth of America, okay? America is just normalizing all type of filth. And this place is begging, you know, for the destruction of ancient Sodom and Gomorrah through fire. Okay? Now, I'm going to play it again, then we can get some pre-sales. But this is pure madness. Alright? And no uproar. Where are the Christians? Where are the Christians, man? Okay? So, there's nothing vocab has to say. Okay? There's nothing, okay, that all these Christian apologists have to say, you know, because apologists means defenders of the gospel. So you should be, you know, defending the madness, all right, that's being normalized, okay, especially here in America, man. All right, so let's play this again, you know, get a few precepts, man.
Vice Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral Lisa Franchetti, told the House Armed Services Committee last month that the Navy is projected to fall 6,000 recruits, or 16%, short of its goal for enlisted sailors this fiscal year. So, they're exploring new recruitment strategies, such as this one.
We reached the moon, but lost in space, I think we got there all too soon. But you know what? I'm coming back for you, baby. I'm coming back for you.
And if that doesn't convince young men to join the Navy, there's this.
La la la, this throat Lady Gaga, boys say hallelujah, give me that ya 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 ya.
Shalom.
So let's go here. Starting now, let's go to Isaiah. All right, 19. You know, and this is why, you know, we should constantly separate more and more, you know, from the society, from these people, you know, at the end of the day, All right, this is the safest place to be because the whole world is just being laden with filth. All right, now this is Isaiah 19. All right, and let's see. Yep, in 14, it said, "The Lord have mingled a perverse spirit in the midst thereof, and they have called Egypt to err in every way, in every work thereof, as a man drunk, as a drunken man staggereth in his vomit." Okay, and the morality of America is likened to a drunken man. See the philosophies and the ways, because America, all right, has pretty much been the motherland, as the scriptures say, the source of abominations in the earth. Okay, so the filth is always the worst here. You see, the things that are normalized and accepted in this society, and Christianity played a major part in that, man. Okay, but all in all, we see, you know, the perverse spirit that's in the midst of America, man. Okay, and it only gets worse. You see, and that's why we should be begging for the destruction of this place, man. All right, this is just filth, man. As a drunk man staggering in his vomit, man. This is what these philosophies have produced. Okay, this is what it has produced. Cause what, when you drink and get intoxicated, you throw up. Okay, and this is the hangover of the doctrines of Babylon, man. Of the cup of Babylon. Okay, we're living in the hangover, man. You see? Now let's go here. Alright. Now, when you go here, which, you know, qualify this precept, when I read Jeremiah 51 and 30, it says, "The mighty men of Babylon," this is speaking of America's military, "have forborne to fight." Okay? "They have remained in their holes. Their might have failed, because in the coming war, the American military is doomed." You see, you gotta think, America has been, you know, demasculating the men for decades. Okay, these are children of feminists. Okay, these are the children and an offspring of a feminist, you know, demasculated society, man. Okay? The American military is out of there, man. It said they might have failed. They have become as women. Okay? They have become as women. And that's in the spirit, but also literal, man. It's like, damn. You see? The military is transing out. Okay, it said they have burned her dwelling places, her bars are broken. Yeah, because you gotta think, American troops are gonna be, you know, spread out. You know, this third world war happened, you know, a lot of them gonna be dispatched, you know, to over there in the Middle East, you know, over there in Saudi, you know, as they're gonna be, you know, dealing with Iran on one front. You know, they're gonna be, hey, they're gonna be dispatched, because the World War III gonna be fought on several fronts. To the missiles on lunch. Okay? And then America is going to be destroyed, but there's going to be a lot of troops that are still in other places fighting, man. Okay? And once they hear about this, hey, look, this is going to be bad for them, man. The American military is the worst place to be right now, man. Okay? According to prophecy, man. Okay? America gonna be destroyed. Yahweh Shah gonna be getting down, you know, in the earth. Okay, and even before America is destroyed, the American military that spread abroad gonna be getting their ass handed to them, man. Then America gonna be destroyed. Then Yahweh Shah return, and then this place is done. Okay. Oh boy, and the military is taking on the spirit of a woman, man. Okay, finished. And then you have, hey, these, I want to mention this. So you have these ex, okay, Marines and Navy SEALs, and they pissed, man. Okay, in this era of the American military, Alright? What they call them, you know, badasses. That era is gone. Okay? So you have this SEAL, you know, who supposedly killed, you know, Bin Laden. Let's see if I can make it. Alright? And he says he can't believe he fought for this BS. SEAL who killed Bin Laden reacts to Navy's, okay, Dairy Queen ambassador. Okay, you see what it is, man. Okay? And what you think these Navy SEALs, these ex-Navy SEALs who feel played by their country, what you think they're going to do in a time of chaos, man? What you think they're going to be doing, okay, when they get chaotic over here, man? Okay, it's going to get real bloody in America, man. All right, it says Biden regime turned the military into a freak show as Navy use, all right, you see this word, you know, you can't say nothing, okay? They use the ENB seller who performs as a Dairy Queen, okay, as a Dairy Queen in recruitment campaign, man, okay? And only thing that's gonna happen under Biden is this place, the nigga, he gave you one or two stimulus checks and he done freaked the place out, man. Okay, he picked up what your beloved Obama left off. Okay, was just doing nothing but running America into the missiles, man. Okay, so it's necessary. This filth is necessary, man. It's vexing, but it's necessary to get the hell out of here, man. You know, so I just want to do a quick response, Lord will you, brothers. And you sisters are edified till next time I say Shalom.